Good morning all. Welcome for this lecture. Today we are going to discuss on source transformation. Okay. Source transformation, it is a procedure which transforms one source into another. Okay. While retaining the terminal characteristics of original source. Right. So meaning of this one is one source can be transformed into another source but retaining its terminal characteristics, okay, of original one. So what are those sources can be transformed? That is, one is voltage source, you can convert into current source, and a current source you can transform to a voltage source. All right. So now this source transformation technique we are going to apply on practical voltage sources and practical current sources. As we know, practical voltage source means voltage source with internal resistance in series, okay, and current source means current source and internal resistance in parallel, okay. These things we know. Now let's convert one to another one. That is, let's take a first one, voltage source into current source. Observe, this is a practical voltage source, okay, between the terminal A and B, okay, A and B. So this is a voltage source, internal resistance is RS. We need to convert this into a current source. Remember, this is the ideal voltage source, okay. Now we need to convert it into current source. What we know the current source? It is the current source representation with internal resistance in parallel. Okay, and remember one thing, this resistance, whatever we have a resistance, internal resistance of a voltage source will remains same, okay, will remains same, that resistance will be remains same in the current source also. Okay, and the next thing is, whatever we have this voltage source terminals, that is very important. That is, this is a positive terminal and it is a negative terminal, okay. So along with this we have to represent, as we have said, this resistance remains same, okay. If it is a RS, this will remains RS. If it is a 5 ohm, then it is also 5 ohm. If it is a 100 ohm, then it is also 100 ohm. Means resistance of a voltage source, internal resistance of a voltage source will remain the same if you transform that voltage source into current source, okay. But that will be in parallel. Here this resistance was in series with the voltage source. In when you transform it, it will, this resistance will be in parallel with current source. Now we have to draw its arrow mark, okay. We have to show current is representing in this way, right? Arrow mark is maybe up or it may be downward, okay. It is based on the terminal of this voltage source, okay. Let's see, this is a positive terminal and this is a negative terminal. Same way we have to represent here. How we have to represent this arrow mark? Okay, arrow mark represents positive. So where is the positive? Upper part. So this has to be represented, okay. So you can observe here, right, this voltage source transforms like this. Now we have shown this current source, but that how much, what is that current we need to calculate? That current is nothing but V divided by R, right? We all are familiar with this, okay. It is equal to V by R. So V is the source voltage, okay. It is represented as Vs divided by resistance is RS, okay. Therefore this will, I current will be represented by Vs by RS. Whatever the value of voltage is there, divided by resistance you do, that current will be your current source, and internal resistance will be remains same. Here it will be in parallel, along with the voltage source it will be in series, okay. I hope it is clear with you. It is true vice versa, okay, but let's discuss that also. Let's convert from current source into voltage source. Now consider a practical current source, okay. Current source resistance is in parallel between the terminal A and B. So this A and B will be remains the same. Now this current source has to be replaced by this one, that we need to transform. as we know, this current source can be represented by voltage source, right? So upper part we have to observe arrow mark. This part always represent positive, tail represents negative. So here it has upward direction, so up is positive, down is negative. So this is a very important thing for us to remember, okay? And next we have this resistance. As we said, internal resistance will be remains the same. If it was in parallel with the current source, then that same resistance will be in series with voltage source, okay? This so resistance will be remains the same, but what is this voltage? Vs will be, now V is equal to what? According to Ohm's law, I into R, okay? You know, you have this, you have I and you know R, both will be given. So multiply those two values, then you get a Vs. That is a magnitude of this voltage source, and this resistance remains the same. Okay, whatever it may be, it is going to remain same. I hope it is clear with you. Let's deal with the numericals based on just a transformation from current source to voltage and voltage source to current source. So before dealing with this, we'll start with a very simple one, then we'll come back to this one. Okay, let's see first example is to convert this into current source. First example is convert this into this voltage, so practical voltage source into current source. Okay, representation wise we know, right? So voltage source was there along with the internal resistance. We are going to represent its current source along with internal resistance in parallel. Only thing is, this whatever resistance, we as we have said, resistance remains the same, so 10 ohm, and here also we have to write 10 ohm, and then now we have to calculate what is this current. Current is equal to what? V divided by R. Do you know V? Yes, they have given how much it is, 100 volts, right? Divided by what is the resistance? It is 10. So how much it is? 10 amperes. So this is your 10 ampere current source. Okay, this is your 10 ampere current source. Have you got this? How to convert this into this? Remember, this internal resistance remains same. Okay, here it is in series with the voltage source, here it is in parallel with the current source. Okay, hope it is clear. Next we'll deal with this numerical. Okay, now we have a practical current source, we need to convert it into voltage source. Sorry, I forgot here, representation of this. Okay, arrow mark. So observe, this is a positive and this is a negative, so it has to be represented like this. Suppose if this is negative and this is positive, okay, what would be the direction of this symbol, means arrow mark? If it this will be there, then this is the representation, okay, downward. This is positive and this is negative, as that of your voltage source. Okay, let's do this for current source. Let's draw the circuit diagram first. Without calculating any values, without knowing any values, we'll draw it. Yes, this, as we know, practical, we are converting from practical current source into the voltage source. Then we have to represent with the voltage symbol, okay? And then along with the voltage source, there will be internal resistance in series. This we have to remember. This we have drawn. It is a skeleton of this. Now we have to put the values as well as the symbol. See, it is upward direction. Upward direction means arrow mark is positive, tail is negative. So same here also, it is positive and this is a negative. Now what about this 2 ohm resistance? It will remains the same. It is a 2 ohm resistance. And what about the voltage source value? Then it is V, right? V has to be there. V is equal to what? I into R. So what is I? Yes, we know the current from current source, it is 10 into what about this resistance? It is 2. So 10 into 2, which is 20 volts. Okay, which gives us 20 volts. Okay, this is 20 volts, 2 ohm resistance. Right? So this is how. I hope this is clear to you people. Huh? Now we'll deal with this numerical. Okay, we'll deal with this numerical. Observe first, and before, okay, we'll start and then afterwards I'll explain. Remember, See, this is between A and B terminal. Always you have to be with terminals A and B. And as I said you, all these are whatever lines are there, no? Those are all wires, flexible wires. You have to imagine like that. Then only you can able to do it. Okay. And now, between A and B, there is what? Voltage source, right? Practical voltage source. And along with this, current source is in parallel. Right? Like this. What we can do is, we'll get only single source. Okay, either maybe current source or voltage source, but a single source we need to get. How many sources are there now? There are two. One is voltage source is there, one more is current source we have. So we'll simplify something and then we'll get a single one. Okay, so for that what we have to do is between this terminal, okay, so between this terminal, this is a practical voltage source that can be convert into your current, practical current source. Okay, don't think that this 12 ampere has to be converted because there is no internal resistance with that. Whenever you not have internal resistance with any source, don't try to convert it. Okay, now we'll convert this one into practical current source. Okay, as we know, this can be done. So resistance remains the same. Yes, we have kept resistance. Voltage source is going to convert into current source, and current source and internal resistance will be in parallel. So this has to be done, right? Okay. So what is the direction you just observed? This is positive and this is negative, means like this, right? Positive and negative. So it should be like this between A and B. Okay. So this 3 ohm remains the same and 15 volts. But what is I? I is equal to V by R. Okay. That is V by R. What is the value of that then? V is how much? V is 15 volts. Okay. I'll write here. V is 15 volts. And what about resistance? It is 3. Then how much current is? 3 ones are 3. 5 za. Okay. 5 ampere. Okay. This is 5 ampere. Now we have converted this practical voltage source into a practical current source, but it is not sufficient. We have along with that is one more current source that also we need to connect. So we need to connect this one, this entire combination. Okay, same thing, just what we have done, nothing, just we have converted this practical voltage source into practical current source. Okay, observe this. Okay, now we'll draw one more time. Current, it is A terminal and this is a B terminal. This is the resistance. This is the current source. And this is one more current source. And current source direction is in this direction. And this current direction is this one. And it is 20 ampere. And it is 5 ampere. And this is 3 ohm. Okay. And one more thing which I need to explain you that. You can add, okay, you can add if voltage sources are in series. Okay, I repeat once, if voltage sources are in series, then you can add it. Sources are can be added, like, you know, algebraic sum you can take. Okay, I cannot say addition, subtraction, I can say that algebraic sum you can take. Okay, similarly, if your current sources are in parallel, okay, if current sources are in parallel, right, then also you can add, means algebraic sum can be taken. Okay, now let's do that, how we can do it. Okay, so this is between A and B terminal. Okay, this is A and this is B. Now there are two current sources which are in parallel, so we can take its addition, we can add it, algebraic sum. Okay, we'll stand here. Okay, yes, if you are standing, which terminal you are reaching first? This is the positive. Okay, then it is plus 5, right? Then again you have to be here only, in the same way you have to move. Then which terminal you are nearby? That is minus, tail of that arrow mark. So minus 12. What is the answer of this algebraic sum? It is. What is the answer of this? Which is minus 7. Which should be known. right? Minus 12. So then so it's 5 minus 12 is minus 7. Is it correct? So now what we can do is, let's take that and you can represent. Okay, so one current source, these two current sources can be replaced by a single current source by taking algebraic sum. Okay, remember current sources will not be in series. Okay, and voltage sources will not be in parallel. If those are there, then you need to do some changes, transformation or shifting, whatever it may be, then you have to perform. Okay, now these two are current sources. Okay, these two current sources we have added algebraically. That is, if we are here, then it should be positive 5, here minus 12, which gives us minus 7. So what do you mean by minus 7? This is A and this is B. This resistance remains the same. Single current source we have now, right? So minus 7, where you are? Here you are, right? Minus means nearby you should be, minus means tail should be this side and this one, okay? Right? So it is 7 ampere current source, and this is the 3 ohm resistance. Now you can leave it like this only, or else you can convert this practical current source into a voltage source. What we can do is, so entire current source can be represented with one voltage source along with the internal resistance in series. So this 3 ohm resistance will be remains the same. Here also 3 ohm resistance, and this 7 ampere means voltage will be what? I into R. I is 7 ampere, resistance is 3 ohm, so 7 threes are 21, right? So 21 volts voltage source, 3 ohm resistance, internal resistance in series with that. Okay, let's glance. Okay, so this we can observe here, which we have done, right? First we have converted it. Okay, and next these two are in parallel, so you can take it, right? And then you have to write be careful about its positive and negative, okay, symbols, okay, which is very important for us. Okay, and next we'll start doing this. Reduce a network shown below to a single voltage source. They have given us, so since till now what we have discussed is very simple networks, this is also a bit simple. It looks bit complex, but it is very simple. We can apply the same techniques which you have followed till now. Okay, and what are the techniques we have followed it, or which are techniques we know? First one is voltage source can be converted into current sources. Okay, our current sources can be transformed into voltage sources. Being internal resistance, with this it should be in series. Current sources it should be in parallel. These two techniques we know, and we know that if current sources are in parallel, okay, algebraic sum can be taken. If voltage sources are in series, then also its algebraic sum can be taken. Okay, which value we have to take? It is based on the algebraic, like, you know, addition and subtraction. Which value is more, that symbol is going to proceed. Okay, let's start solving this. I'll first once give you the hint, and then we can proceed with to solve. Okay, now observe this. See, this is A terminal and B terminal. Okay, so now this is a voltage source, it is in series with this combination, right? So this is what a practical current source. Can we convert this into a voltage, practical voltage source? Then what happens here? One voltage source is there already. Okay, what we can do is, this source is already is there, and then this can be converted into one source and one resistance. It comes like this, right? We'll think about later about its value and all, but it remains like this. Okay, once we convert it, right? So this practical current source can be converted into practical voltage source. बराबर. एंड नेक्स्ट व्हाट वी हैव इज सेकंड सेकंड यू कंसिडर दिस. हियर वी हैव वन करेंट सोर्स विच इज इंडिपेंडेंट एंड हियर इज वन वोल्टेज सोर्स विच इज प्रैक्टिकल वोल्टेज सोर्स दैट कैन बी कन्वर्टेड बिकॉज दिस इज द करेंट सोर्स. ओके दिस टू आर इन पैरेलल करेंट. इफ यू हैव अ पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन प्रिफर टू कन्वर्ट ऑल द सोर्सेज इन टू करेंट सोर्सेज बिकॉज इन इफ करेंट सोर्सेज आर इन पैरेलल देन यू कैन एड इट. ओके एंड देन इफ यू हैव अ वोल्टेज सोर्सेज मेक दैट शुड बी इन कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज ताकि यू कैन कनेक्ट मीन्स यू कैन टेक अ अल्जेब्रिक सम एट लास्ट. ओके सो दिस सिंपल रूल्स इफ यू फॉलो देन इजिली यू कैन गेट इट. फर्स्ट ब्रांच. Okay, this is the first branch and we have taken its earlier one and we have converted it, right? A second branch is a old practical voltage source. Let's convert it into a current source. Okay, this is a current source and this is a resistance of this one, internal resistance. And one more combination you have, that is one current source is already there. Okay, this is the second branch, right? We have a third branch and fourth branch. Let's see about the third branch. What about it is between A terminal and B terminal. Okay, it is A terminal and it is a B terminal. Between that it is connected. These are all. Right? This is first branch, second branch got over. Next is third. Third branch is what? It is a practical voltage source. Let's convert that into current source. So this is a current source and its internal resistance. Okay? And at last fourth branch is consist of a simple what current source. Okay, now based on its representation we'll do it. Okay, so sorry, this one will also be connected, right? So this is the voltage source, it is minus and it is a positive. And then what about this? It is direction like this, means it is positive and it is negative. Okay, and then if you are converted this second branch into current source, then positive comes this side, right? This is a positive and this is negative, so it comes like this. And then internal resistance, and they have given in a second branch, say in that second branch again a second branch is 6 ampere. And if you convert third branch, it gives us like this direction, and last branch has this direction. Okay, right. Now what we have to do is these all are what current sources. Almost all, most of them are current sources, and only one single branch is of voltage source. What you have to do is convert these two. You can take a addition because, as we know, voltage sources, if they are in series, those can be added. So add these two, okay? Add these two, and then single source you will get voltage source and resistance in series. What you have to do is then again convert this voltage practical source into current source. Last, what we get, all current sources, okay, all current sources you get in parallel, and all these internal resistance are also in parallel. So all current sources are in parallel, you take a algebraic sum, and then all resistances are in parallel, take its equivalent resistance in parallel. Okay, then you can represent with a single, you get a single current source with a single internal resistance along with that in parallel. Okay, I hope you have got this. Let's solve it. Let's solve this. Okay, observe. We'll start doing it. See, this is between A and B terminal. Okay, 5 volts we have taken, 5 volts. Okay. And next 2 ampere is there, that means it is a practical current source. Let's convert this into a voltage source. Yes, we have a voltage source and resistance in series. Let's convert it to what is the value of it. So we require V is equal to I into R. I value is how much? 2, and resistance is 5. But how much it is? 10. 2, 5 is 10. 10 volts. What about its direction? Observe this. It is this direction, means it is a positive and it is a negative. Therefore, this is positive and this is negative. And 5 ohm resistance was in parallel with the current source. Now it should be in series with the resistance. So there are 2 voltage sources which are connected in series. Okay. And next, this is first branch. Okay. Second branch, third branch and fourth branch. In the second branch, this is the first branch and this is the second branch. you can take A branch and B branch. Now we'll observe about second branch. In that A, you can think A is what? It's a practical voltage source. Okay, second branch is what? In that A and B, so this is also practical voltage source. Convert that into a current source. Yes, one voltage source is converted and we have kept it, right? So what is, and internal resistance is 1 ohm, it will be also remains the same but in parallel. What about a current? Current is how much? Current is V by R. V voltage source is how much? 2 divided by 1. How much it is? 2 amperes. Okay, this is 2 amperes. And then what about a B branch? It is a simply one current, simple independent current source. We'll take one independent current source. Okay, next we'll come to third branch. What about third branch? It is also voltage source. Let's convert this into current source. Okay, current source into its resistance. Observe here also the direction. Okay, what about its direction? This is positive and this is negative, means like this, right? We have taken this direction. All right, next, this third branch is current source we require, that is I is equal to V by R again. V is 9 volt and R is 3 ohm, then 3 ones are 3 threes. So 3 ampere current you get. What is the direction? Negative, positive, so like this. Then it has to be written. Okay, 3 ohm resistance will be remains the same in as an internal resistance in parallel with the current source. And then last branch is 6 ampere current source, which is independent. So you can connect like that only. Is it clear? Okay. Next. Next thing is, so what we can do, this simplification. Two voltage sources are in series. What we can do is, let's move from this side, A to B. Okay. We'll move. While moving, which terminal you reach first? Negative. So it is minus 5. And then let it be 5 ohm. And then what about the source? Which terminal you will reach first? Plus 10. So what is the algebraic of this? It is plus 5. Okay, plus 5. Then what is the equivalent voltage source of this? It should be, you will reach first positive and then negative. Okay, of 5 volt. Observe. Right? 5 volt. And what about the resistance of it? It is a 5 ohm resistance. It remains same in series. Okay. And then these are, see, observe, these can be, as I told you, these are all wires. Instead of connecting here, I can open it and I can connect this wire here. I can disconnect it and I can connect this wire. Okay. This 6 ampere, I can disconnect this wire and I can connect here. Okay. Here also, I can do like this. See, right? All these things can be connected in this way. Only thing is, this has to be converted because it is completely parallel. So, as I told you, in parallel combination, you prefer to get in current sources in parallel. Okay, you don't take voltage sources in parallel. Alright. So, now we will convert only this thing into parallel. So, now this you have a, voltage source. Convert this into a current source. We are now bit familiar with that. Suddenly, immediately we can do it. So, this is a voltage source. Okay, current source can be written as I is equal to V by R. V is 5 volt divided by 5 ohm. It is 1 ampere. Direction also you can observe. It should be written like this, right? 5 ohm resistance, internal resistance will be in parallel. Observe how many sources are in parallel. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, just stand here. On every sources you be here and then tell me which is your nearest sign and its value. Okay, if you are here, then what you will reach first, it is positive plus 1, next is plus 2, next is minus 6, next is minus 3, next is minus 6. What about the value of it? It is 1 plus 2, 3. Plus 3, minus 3 get cancelled. Minus 6, which is minus 12. Means, if you are here, okay, if you are here at A, then you have to reach negatives, means tail of the source. okay. And then what about resistances? Observe which all are resistances: 5 ohm and 1 ohm and 3 ohm. Okay, these three are in parallel. So let's take its parallel combination. 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by 5 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by 3. If you do this calculation, 1 by Rp you get, and next you can take its reciprocal, you get 0.65 ohm. Okay, do this and check it once. I may be wrong, you just check once and tell me, right? So this is 0.65 ohms and this is minus 12 ampere. Now they have asked us to calculate the single voltage source. Okay, they have specified it. Alright, then now what we can do is, this is a practical current source. We are very familiar with this, that to convert into voltage source. This resistance remains the same. Okay, but what about the voltage source? Okay, this is a tail and this is the arrow mark. So it is negative and positive. V is equal to I into R, which is 12 into 0.65, which is 7.82 volts. Okay, hope it is clear to you. Solve this numerical, take as a homework, okay, and then solve it and share with me. Okay, we'll discuss in the next class. Thank you.